God. Because you ain't going to be laying down with everything.
Amen.
Are y'all with me? If you really think God is here.
Yes.
What do you mean? As a sexual transmitted disease, you don't have to worry about it if you living right. Are y'all with me?
Yes.
Hallelujah. It prolongs life. Fourthly, it produces a sense of security.
Yes.
It produces a sense of security. See, it goes back to what my wife was talking about. When she began to discover, and even when I began to discover who I am in Christ Jesus,
yes,
and understand that I have eternal security in him, why do I really care about what you think?
Come on.
You think about why those, you look at those that were in the civil rights movement, many of them were young men and women that marched because they lost the fear of man. They understood, they saw freedom so important that it was a God-given right, they weren't going to let anybody keep them from that freedom.
Yes.
Are y'all with me? So they could stick dogs on them, and guess what? They could say, we shall overcome. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Some of us wouldn't be singing that. We wouldn't be singing that. We'd be like, turn up. Are y'all with me? But they were able to focus on what the goal was at hand because they saw something deeper.
Yes.
They saw freedom. They saw today. They saw black kids and white kids come to school together.
Yes.
They saw us, blacks, whites, red, yellows, having the right to vote.
Yes.
They saw something deeper. Because they saw something deeper, they had eternal security. He said, you can damage the flesh, but you can't destroy my spirit.
Come on.
And truth, the Bible tells, I mean, Martin Luther King has said, says, truth always has a way of swinging back, the pendulum back toward justice.
Justice, amen.
And you got to understand that. No matter what wrong goes around you, that truth will come out. Amen?
Amen.
That God is in control.
And it goes back to that assurance, too, because a lot of times as Christians, we're taken out not just by people, but we're taken out by our circumstances. We get distracted so easily. So it produces a sense of security where if your bank account is overdrawn or if things aren't going your way on your job, you can just say, God, you got this because I know your nature. You're faithful. My favorite scripture is now to him that's able to keep me from falling and present me faultless before the presence of others with exceeding joy. That's God's promise to me. But I have to be in him to receive that. Amen. So my motivation is I want to be in you. And if everything's not aligned up, God, I know you're going to line it up. May not be how I want, when I want, but you got this. God got this.
So he can bring it before his presence with exceeding joy. Exceeding joy.
Sense
Amen.
Of security. Yes.
Amen. Let's go on to the next new one. Come on. Fifth point. You ready for something new? Are you ready for something new?
Yeah.
Y'all still here?
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure. One, it produces life. Everybody say it produces life.
It produces life.
Say the fear of the Lord.
The fear of the Lord.
Okay, I hear them over here. Let me hear this side. Say the fear of the Lord.
Fear of the Lord.
Okay, y'all sound like y'all sleep over here. Let me go back over here. Everybody say the fear of the Lord.
The fear of the Lord.
Okay. Oh, they loud over here. Come on. Everybody say the fear of the Lord.
The fear of the Lord.
Okay, y'all getting there. Okay. Let's say it all together. The fear of the Lord.
The fear of the Lord.
Produces life.
Produces life.
Oh, man, it might make me want to step over here. Proverbs 14 and 27. The fear, the step for Jesus, of course. The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life to depart from the snares of death. How many of these trappings of the enemy?
Amen. Yes.
And how many know when you fear God, he keeps you out of a lot of mess that you have no business being in?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Man, I thank God for my parents, being godly parents. Didn't do everything perfect. Nobody does. But one thing they did instill in me was the fear of the Lord. It was many times I would, when everybody was about to go get high, everybody was about to go. I was in the marching band, and I was in different organizations in school that where people did things as a group. Guess what? The Holy Ghost would come upon me and be like, no, I can't do that. You know, I know mom and dad ain't here, but I could hear my mom saying, God sees everything.
Yes.
God sees everything.
Yeah.
Or I thought about the God of my father, Pop Sanders, that I was going to have to deal with.
Amen.
When I finished doing what I had to do. Amen?
Yeah.
And so it produces life. When we walk in the fear of the Lord, we are stronger spiritually than we could be otherwise. When we walk in the fear of the Lord, we are stronger spiritually than we could be otherwise. Let me tell you something. When you're reading your word on a daily basis, when you're praying to God daily, when you're studying this word and meditating on a daily basis, when the attacks of the enemy come, you're ready for those attacks.
Yes.
Secondly,
the fear of the Lord is like a fountain that continually springs up with spiritual vitality and strength. And when I think of fountain that springs up, that's forgiveness too. I mean, you keep your mercy account full. You want to release people quickly. That's what produces life. I don't regard my feelings more than I regard God. So it's not about me and holding this unforgiveness. Thank you, Lord, for giving me this experience. And that brings forth that fountain that continually springs up with spiritual vitality and strength. We're giving back to God everything that could hold us back.
So did you just get what she just said? She just said something real powerful. Forgiveness keeps the flow of the Spirit in your life.
Yes.
On the contrary, on the opposite end, unforgiveness stops the flow of life.
Yes.
In your life. Do you understand why the enemy tries to bind believers with unforgiveness? Why he tries to move you in your relationships with your children, with your baby mamas and your baby daddies, with your, because we have a diverse population now.
Yes.
Everything is not just pretty with our families.
Yes.
With our, so you have moms getting mad at children and children getting mad at moms and dads getting mad. Are y'all with me?
Yes.
And so it's important that you have forgiveness in your life so that the flow of God, even if you don't understand everything, I forgive, I release them, God, because I'm not going to let this hinder the flow of God in my life.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes, come on.
You got to do that. Amen?
Yes.
Because while you're holding this unforgiveness and you're stopping God's blessing, that other person that you haven't forgiven, they're going to sleep.
Amen.
While your blood pressure is getting higher, guess what? Theirs getting lower. They just relaxing. Get that picture. Again, unforgiveness is like drinking poison and expecting the other person to get sick.
Yes.
Turn to your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
I'm not drinking any more poison.
I'm not drinking any
more
poison.
Come on, come on. Turn to your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
The days of drinking poison.
The days of drinking poison.
Is over.
Is over.
Amen. 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 It enables us as Christians to walk a cleaner, closer, thus avoiding the temptation and the traps of the devil.
Yes.
So when you don't walk in unforgiveness, when you walk and allow that fountain of life, then the Spirit of God, let me tell you something else. The Spirit of God can move through you.
Yes.
How many ever had the Spirit of God speak through you? And you know it's the Spirit of God because you know you weren't even in any condition for the Spirit of God to speak through you. But he, because when I say that, you're weak.
Mm-hmm.
But God speaks through you in spite of you.
Anyway.
Because you've been in that word and you've been focused on that word. So even when you felt at your weakest point, the Holy Spirit speaks through you. That's that fountain of life.
Yes.
Have you ever had God give you patience with your kids when you know you should be losing it right in that moment?
Hmm.
Huh?
Amen.
You should be just about to go off and you'd be like, no. And they stop and look at you crazy. They said, we better listen. Because it's something deeper than what I normally see.
Amen.
Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Amen? Okay, let's look at the next point. Point six. It makes all of life better. These are reasons why you should have the fear of God in your life. It makes all of life better. Proverbs
15, verse 16. Better is little with the fear of the Lord than great treasure and trouble therewith.
Now this verse means it's better to have limited resources and be in the will of God than to have plenty and trouble that comes along with it. How many know? I'd rather have a little bit with a lot of God than a lot of bit and none of God.
Come on, come on. Yes.
See, some of you don't understand how important that is. Some of you look at your friends that may have more things than you, be like, man, I wish I had that because they have everything. But I tell you something. I always realize this. When I worked with, we were in ministry, full-time ministry. A lot of times we get to talk to millionaires and billionaires, and I meet them, and I won't disclose some of the names of some of the people I was grace to meet across the nation. I look at their lives, they'd be so jacked up.
Yes.
And they'd be like, man, the kids cussing them out, no respect in the home. And I look at how I was raised with not as much as them, but yet we came out respected and reverencing authority. I'd be like, man, I wouldn't trade my life for their life any day.
Yes.
And so you got to understand that you have something greater. This world is so materialistic right now. We make it all about things, but it's so much more than things. Let me tell you something, parents, because a lot of us are working on our jobs and we work long hours and we make sacrifices for our kids to give them things, not realizing sometimes we need to not take the overtime and spend time with our kids.
Yes, yes.
You cannot buy your kids back with things.
That's good.
Nothing beats spending time with your children.
Yes, yes.
Let me tell you something. They will only be five one time. Mm. They will only be seven one time.
Mm-hmm.
They will only be 12 one time. They will only be teenagers one time.
Yes.
I know they may be getting on your nerves, but just remember, it's only going to be one time that, and you're going to, and guess what? They're going to be 20 again, only one time. And you cannot buy that time back with gifts and things.
That's so true.
The greatest gift you can give your children is you.
Yes.
That's the greatest gift. And I know it sounds too simple. I know some of you may have toddlers right now, and they may be driving you crazy. You're glad that we have a nursery so you can get a break. But I'm telling you, enjoy that time, because guess what? When they get big and they're talking back, you're going to wish they were toddlers again. Are you with me?
Yeah.
There's some days I wish, oh, man, it'd be nice to just change the diaper, because I can handle that. Are y'all with me?
Mm-hmm. Come on.
You see, but that's what we got the nursery for. I can go play in the nursery. I can go home and see my big kids. Amen?
Amen.
And so what am I saying? Enjoy the journey. Enjoy the moment. And understand it's more. Let me tell you something. All these things that we're trying to acquire, flat screen TVs, how many know they're making it real easy? It says sales are going up right now. Gas has dropped. They want people to spend more money in the economy. Guess what? Give you a sense of urgency. Oh, forget the budget. Don't worry about the budget. Let's think. Times are good. Let me tell you something. You go get yourself, in the name of Christmas,